All right. We had left at third part of this exercise. Last question, statement sums. Yash scored 40 marks in the test if he was given 3 marks for correct answer and deducted 1 mark for wrong answers. If the scoring was a little different, 4 marks were to be awarded for correct answer and 2 were to be deducted for incorrect answer, then he would have scored 50 marks. You want to find out how many questions were there in the test. We started by assuming the number of questions he answered correctly, the number of right answers he gave, and the number of wrong answers he gave as x and y respectively. That would mean that the total number of questions are x plus y, assuming that he had attempted all questions. In first case, for every right answer, the score will be plus 3. So for x right answers, the score will be 3x. For wrong answers, one wrong answer takes away minus 1. And y wrong answers, the score deducted will be minus y. And his total score in this case is 3x minus 4y. 3x minus y equals to 40. As I said the other day, if you want, you may write this or you can directly form your equation. It's up to you. For the time being, I would like you to write this down so that you are aware later on how the equation was formed. So in the second case, if the scoring was different, for every right answer, plus 4 is given. For every wrong answer, 2 marks are being deducted. So he is answering x questions correctly. So his score will be 4x, and he has answered y questions incorrectly. So for that, the score deducted will be 2y. And according to question, in this case, the total is 50. So the total score he obtains for correct answers and incorrect answer is 50. This is the second equation. So this will have a unique solution. A1 over A2 is not equal to B1 by B2. Probably you have solved already. Kindly tell me.
X is 15 and Y is 5.
So he answered 15 questions correctly, 5 incorrect.
Y 5, X 15.
Total questions 20.
Total questions were 20. Anyone who did not solve? Those who are just writing down, please ensure that all the problem sums we are doing currently, I am helping you make equations. You have to solve these on your own. Please don't write the answer like the way I have written. After writing down the equations, you have to show your work. You can use any of the 3 algebraic methods, elimination, substitution, or cross multiplication, whichever is you're confident about. Rajvansh, Pache, can you hear me? Okay. I want you to rename yourself. And why don't you do it in your profile, in the settings? I wonder if other teachers also ask you to do the same. Before we do fourth part of the question, let's take up fifth one. The area of a rectangle gets reduced by 9 square units if the length is reduced by 5 units and the breadth is decreased by 3, breadth is increased by 3 units. This is the first condition that is given to us. We want to change the length and breadth and the area is affected. In second case, you change the length and breadth again, the area is affected. Similar to the question where you change the numerator and denominator and the fraction is affected. Same way. It's kind of similar, not exactly, because in case of fraction, you're given the exact answer for the new fraction form. In this case, the new area that you obtain after altering the length and the breadth is given as given in terms of original area. If you consider the first part here, if you modify the length and breadth, the new area is equal to the original area decreased by 9. Obviously, all these values are in square units. So in order to form this equation, we need the new dimensions as well as the original dimensions. And to begin with, we will let what were the dimensions were originally. As they are asking, find the dimensions of the rectangle. They are asking you to find out what are the original dimensions. So you can work with LB as such, length ko L let kar sakte ho, breadth ko B let kar sakte ho, or you can start by letting these as X and Y. So let's write down that length is X and breadth is Y. Simply writing down, if the length is represented as X and breadth is represented as Y, the area will be product of the length and the breadth, XY square units. In first case, new length and new breadth. And then find out the new area. Form the equation. In first case, the new area is actually equal to original area reduced by 9 square units. So this is how you'll form your first equation. Similar to this, in the second case, write down what is the new length, what is the new breadth, and then what will be the new area, and what is given as the relation between the new area and the original area. In I think first case, they are saying that the length has been reduced by 5 units. So it will be X minus 5 units. The breadth is increased
by 3 units.
Y plus 3 units. The new area will be equal to X minus 5 multiplied by Y plus 3. So you can simplify the product here, or you can just form your equation. Again, writing these three things is not necessary. Aap directly according to question likh ke equations form kar sakte ho. These steps are not necessary. You may form the equations directly if you're okay with that. So new area X minus 5 multiplied by y plus 3 equals to xy. The original area is from the values we assumed in the beginning, minus 9. Simplify the product, xy will get cancelled. You will be left with terms containing x, y, and a constant.
(3x - 5, y - 6) = 0.
You've transposed the values to the right hand side.
Yes, ma'am, I use cross multiplication method.
Okay. So as you can see, the product XY is cancelled. You have 3X minus 5Y minus 6 equals to 0. This is equation number 1. Those who are doing side by side, see if you have obtained equation 1.
Yes, ma'am.
In the second case, you want to modify the length by increasing it by 3. So new length is X plus 3 units. The new breadth is to be increased by 2 units. So Y plus 2 units. And then the new area. X plus 3 multiplied with Y plus 2. In the second case, when you alter the length and the breadth, the area increases by 67 square units. The new area is equal to original area plus 67 square units. So new area is the product of the new dimensions.
L plus 3b equal to 61.
You've done in L and B. Okay. After simplification, you get 2x plus 3y. 61 minus 61 equals
minus 61 is equals to 0.
This is equation number 2. And then you can solve to find out the dimensions. Length
17 units and breadth is 9 units.
If anyone is solving at the moment, should we wait?
Yes, ma'am, wait. Ma'am, done.
Ansh, can you hear me?
Roll number 2.
Yes, ma'am.
Beta, why are you joining so late?
Ma'am, wo network connection tha.
Network connection, I think, period ke mid mein aake chal padta hai. Hai na, fir aap, like 20 minutes ke liye class lagate ho aur fir kharab ho jata hai.
नहीं मैम वो चल रहा था सुबह से तो मैंने अभी लगा ली था आपने
ठीक चलेगा ना अब
मैम अब चलेगा
क्वेश्चन नंबर 4th इम्पोर्टेंट वन प्लेसेस ए एंड बी आर 100 किलोमीटर्स अपार्ट ऑन अ हाईवे वन कार स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम ए एंड अदर स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम बी एट द सेम टाइम द कार्स ट्रेवल इन द सेम डायरेक्शन At different speeds, they meet in 5 hours. So this is something you have to keep in mind. They are traveling at different speeds. If they travel in the same direction, then they meet in 5 hours. If they travel towards each other, they meet in 1 hour. What are the speeds of the two cars? Now, keep one thing in mind. You've been asked for speeds of the cars. So obviously, we will be assuming the speeds of the car. But other than that, you are given time in the question. The time after they meet each other. Along with that, you're given a distance between the two places from where they are starting. So in order to form the equations to solve and find out the speeds, you have to decide what you want to use. Do you want to work with time? Time se apne equation banani, obviously, all of them should be representing time, whatever values you use to make the equation, or you can use distance, whichever you do. In this case, we do it with the help of distance covered. The distance covered by the two cars in the given time, assuming that they are starting from places A and B. Before you write this down, just observe. Let us say we have places A and B represented as such. The distance between these two places is 100 kilometers. So there is a car at A, let's mark it as car A, and there is a car at point B, let's say it's car B. First car ki speed aap let kar sakte ho x kilometers per hour, second car ki let kar sakte hain hum y kilometers per hour. If they travel in the same direction, so let us say they are traveling towards B in this direction from left to right, and after traveling for 5 hours, they meet each other at a point, say P. If the cars are traveling in the same direction, so 5 hours ki drive ke baad dono cars ek dusre ko meet karti hain, and let us say the cars meet at P. So car A covers a distance AP. excuse me. AP is the distance covered by car A in 5 hours. In 5 hours, distance covered by car A. And car B starts from point B. And it covers this distance from B to P. Just tell me if this part is clear, how I have assumed the values and why we have written it this way.
Yes,
दोनों cars अलग अलग point से चल रही हैं और एक point पे meet कर रही हैं. तो जो उनका beginning point है journey का up to the destination is where they meet, let us say. So P is the destination where they actually come across each other and they are together. So car A starts from A, goes up to P, A to P, the distance covered in 5 hours. Then car B starts from B and goes up to P in 5 hours. The distance covered by car B is BP, from B to P. And with the help of the distance covered, can you write down, with the help of time taken and the speed. We have the time for which the cars are traveling. We have the speeds assumed for both cars. Can you find out the distance?
5x and 5y.
Distance is given by speed into time.
Speed into time.
So that's what we will be using. Time, unhone bataya hai, speed humne let ki hai. We can find out the distance each car is covering. So, pehli car ki speed hai x and it travels for 5 hours. The distance covered will be 5x kilometers. Second car with the speed of y kilometers per hour travels for 5 hours. The distance covered will be 5y kilometers. Anyone with questions at this point? Now, the next thing is how to make equation. Yes, Manroop?
Excuse me, ma'am. I can't understand the part after distance. Ma'am, you have written the formula of distance. Mm-hmm. Distance equals x into t. Ma'am, I can't understand that part.
You're not familiar with this, that distance is covered by speed multiplied with time?
Ma'am, yes, I'm familiar with the formula, but
go ahead.
Here we have taken the speed as x and y, mm-hmm. and we have multiplied it with the time taken, if I'm not wrong.
Yes. That's okay. Right. The speed will be same. Either you're talking about the first case or the second case. Speed will be x for the first car, y for the second car. Only the time for which the cars are traveling changes. So in this case, when they were traveling in the same direction, both the cars travel for 5 hours individually.
Okay, ma'am, it's clear now.
Now, with the help of whatever we have obtained till now, humne obtain kiya ki dono cars ne 5-5 hours mein kitna distance cover kar liya. With the help of this and whatever is given to you, you have to form an equation. Now for that, you can just go back to the figure over here. I'm going to mark the distances covered by both cars in the figure itself. So car A covers a distance of 5x kilometers. I'm just not writing the units here. And car B covers a distance of 5y kilometers. So in the figure here, you can see distances are marked. Car A ne kitna distance cover kiya hai? Car B ne kitna distance cover kiya hai? Aur in dono ke beech mein, before they started their journey, kitna distance tha? Using these three, can we form an equation?
5x minus 5y is equal to 100.
AP minus BP equals AB. Jo distance car A ne cover kiya, usme se car B ka agar distance nikal diya jaye, to aapko pata chal jayega dono cars ke beech mein kitna distance tha. Observe it from the figure. AP from A to P. उस लाइन सेगमेंट में से अगर हम बी टू पी वाला सेगमेंट सब्ट्रैक्ट कर दें, यू विल बी लेफ्ट विद लाइन सेगमेंट ए बी. दैट्स हाउ आई एम गोइंग टू मेक माय इक्वेशन. यू गेट 5x माइनस 5y इक्वल्स टू 100. इज दिस क्लियर?
यस मैम.
सिंप्लीफाई, योर इक्वेशन कम्स आउट टू बी x माइनस y इक्वल्स टू 20. Mark it as 1. Just like this, we want to form the equation for second case. Again, right now, since we are doing it for the first time, maine bahut detail mein likha hai. In exam, it's not necessary. But even if you write down all these details, it just shows that you know what you're doing. And if you want to write down the equations directly from here, that's also fine. After assuming the values, the speeds of the cars, writing down that, let's say they meet at P, and then you can just write down 5x minus 5y equals to 100. Anyone with questions at this point? Solving is easy, quite easy for this one, but equations banane wala kaam thoda sa difficult hai. Difficult bhi nahi kahenge. Obviously, we are using a couple of concepts here. So once you know what we are doing, you can solve it very easily. Before I proceed, if anyone has any questions.
No, ma'am.
Anyone who's writing down? Okay. Second case, if the cars were traveling towards each other. So I'm again showing it with the help of the figure here. At A, I've got car A, and B point, I've got car B. The speed of car A is X kilometers per hour. The speed of car B is Y kilometers per hour. If the cars travel towards each other, they meet in 1 hour. And let's say they meet at point Q. So car A travels for 1 hour from A to Q. Itna distance car A cover kar rahi hai in 1 hour. Car B starts from B and goes up to Q. This is the distance covered by car B. With the help of the speed and the time given, the time for which each of the cars is traveling, let us find out the distance they are covering in that time interval. Distance covered by car A in 1 hour. It is AQ. Again, use the relation, distance equals to speed into time.
So X kilometer.
This will be X kilometers. And just like this for the second car, in 1 hour, the distance covered is from B to Q. This will be Y multiplied by 1. Now you have to use these values to form your equation. I'm going to label this in the diagram. The distance covered by car A this is X, or simply let's write down 1X kilometers. and this one will be 1 y kilometers. And the two
x
places
plus y is 100.
The two places are 100 kilometers apart. In this case, distance covered by the first car plus the distance covered by the second car will tell you what is the total distance between the two places. Some portion is covered by car A, some of it is covered by B. The total will tell you the total distance between the two places. So x plus y comes out to be 100 here. This is equation number 2. This one I think can be solved orally. The distance, the speeds of the two cars.
X is 60 and y is 40.
Speed of the first car, x kilometers per hour, and the second car, 40 kilometers.
40 kilometers per hour.
It's very important, although all the statement sums in this chapter are important, but this one has been asked in board exams many a times. I hope you've all done this.
Yes, ma'am.
Do go over this answer, because later on there is another question where we talk about speeds and distances. Us case mein aapke paas thoda different way hai solving ka. If the students have done this, those who have done this, it's only for them. Sometimes you are taught to do questions containing a speed. जिसमें स्पीड डिस्टेंस की बात कर रहे हैं हम, आपको करवाते हैं रिलेटिव स्पीड से इक्वेशंस बनवा के. रिलेटिव स्पीड्स आप सिर्फ तब कैलकुलेट करोगे इफ द ऑब्जेक्ट्स मेंशन्ड इन द क्वेश्चन उनकी स्पीड अफेक्ट हो रही है बाय ईच अदर. यहां पे कार्स की स्पीड एक दूसरे की स्पीड को अफेक्ट नहीं कर रही. सो ये इंडिपेंडेंटली अलग अलग से आपने स्पीड्स लेट करनी है और फिर इक्वेशन बनानी है. That is a different case, and those who are wondering ke main kaun si situation ki baat kar rahi hun, there is a question where we have a boat traveling in a stream. So there is a stream of water, obviously water flow kar raha hai, to uski bhi speed hogi, aur jo boat travel kar rahi hai uski bhi speed hai, whether it's being rowed by a man or it's a motor boat. In either case uski bhi kuch speed hogi. Now the speed of the water affects the speed of the boat. Agar boat travel kar rahi hai pani ke flow ke sath, उनकी स्पीड इकट्ठी हो जाती है. बट इफ दे आर द बोट इज बीइंग रोड अगेंस्ट द फ्लो ऑफ वाटर, तो उसकी स्पीड कम हो जाएगी. दिस इज अ नॉर्मल कॉन्सेप्ट. थिंक ऑफ इट कि अगर आप ड्राइव कर रहे हो और यू आर गोइंग अपवर्ड्स ऑन अ फ्लाईओवर, तो वो इंक्लिनेशन की वजह से आपकी स्पीड कम होती है. एंड इफ यू आर ट्रेवलिंग डाउनवर्ड्स, स्पीड इंक्रीजेस, जस्ट लाइक दैट. तो उस केस में आप रिलेटिव स्पीड लिख सकते हो, यहां पे नहीं लिख सकते. वन वेरी गुड स्टूडेंट एक्चुअली डिड दिस क्वेश्चन रॉन्ग जस्ट बिकॉज वो मिक्सअप हो गया था. उसको रिलेटिव स्पीड वाला कॉन्सेप्ट याद था, तो दैट चाइल्ड डिड द क्वेश्चन दिस क्वेश्चन विद दैट कॉन्सेप्ट, तो वो गलत हो जाएगा. एंड आई एम मेंशनिंग दिस बिकॉज आई फील दैट मेजोरिटी ऑफ यू आर डूइंग दिस. Maybe majority of you have already done the chapter, so that's why, in case any one of you has done that question with the relative speed, just be careful, don't mix up the two. Question number 2 of the exercise, as I discussed, again an important question. For what values of the variables here, the pair has infinite many solutions. For infinitely many solutions, the condition is a1 over a2 equals to b1 by b2 equals to c1 by c2. We will use this condition in order to find out the missing variables. And as I mentioned earlier, aapke paas jitne variables missing honge, you require minimum number, that minimum number of equations to find out the values. I'll just start with the answer here. Question number two, first part. Write down the pairs of the equation and start by applying the condition for infinitely many solutions. हम चेक नहीं कर रहे कंडीशन, हम यूज कर रहे हैं. कन्वर्टिंग माई इक्वेशन इन टू स्टैंडर्ड फॉर्म, फर्स्ट वन एज वेल एज द सेकेंड वन. The complete expression on the right hand side, I am putting it together in a bracket. Since this expression on the right hand side represents my constant term, this is the constant term in second equation. Maine is pure expression ko bracket mein likha hai. If you write this whole expression in bracket, it will be easier to bring it to the left hand side. You only need to change the sign outside, not for each of the terms in this expression. We are given that the pair should have infinitely many solutions. So we will need the ratios to be same for the coefficients. A1 by A2 should be equal to B1 by B2 equals to C1 by C2. Coefficients of X, coefficients of Y. Kindly ensure that you are writing down the signs correctly. So these are the three ratios that we have. You can take them in pairs. So we have three ratios here, first, second, and the third one. Out of these three, take any two pairs. Group kar lo inko, first with the second one, second with the third one, or you can even take first with the third one. आपको कोई दो pairs चाहिए आगे equations बनाने के लिए. So I am taking these two and these two. Take ratio 1 equal to ratio 2. उसको simplify करके आपको equation number 1 मिलेगी. Take ratio number 2 equals to ratio number 3. उसको solve करके आपको equation number 2 मिलेगी. Tell me what is the simplified answer? Taking ratio number 2 and ratio number 3 equal to each other. Cross multiply and simplify. Now, as you can see, we had two variables missing in the question. हमें दो variables की value find out करनी थी. आपके पास यहाँ पे दो equations बन गई हैं in those variables. Equation 1 and equation number 2. You have two linear equations in two variables. And you will solve it by using any of the methods that you are comfortable with and find out what will be the value of A and B. Now, it does not matter which ratios you are grouping together to obtain this pair of linear equations. Maine first, second, second, third liya tha. Aap do pairs ko kisi bhi way mein agar solve karoge and you solve that pair of linear equations, you will get the same answer. I'm just going to use substitution. B comes out to be 1, therefore A comes out to be 5.
Fine.
I think it's time for your next class. You may all leave. If you have not written, I can share a screenshot for this one.
Ma'am, please share a screenshot.
Okay, I will share it in the group.
Thank you, ma'am.
God bless you.